All right, so it can be a little bit confusing trying to buy a hobby radio and receiver and hooking it up to your Lego motors and servos. So I'm going to show you what I did here. First of all, with the radio, it can be difficult to figure out which receiver goes with which radio, and then once you do, sometimes people have trouble binding the two and then it's worthless. So what I've got for you here is this radio and receiver comes together and it's already bound, so you don't have to worry about any of that. Of course, links for all this stuff will be in the description. This was $30 right here. The next thing you're going to need is an ESC, or electronic speed controller. And this is going to power your Lego motors. This was $9. And the ESC takes power from your battery, delivers it to your motor, and it also powers the radio. The transmitter throttle is on channel 2, so when you're wiring this together, you're going to put the ESC on channel 2, and you want the black negative wire on the right-hand side there. Now the next thing we're going to need is a servo, and I found these sort of Lego compatible servos here. They have some Lego Technic holes and they have some regular Lego pegs there, and a Technic peg to receive the servo actuator, and then they take a regular servo PWM signal, so you can use that with this radio here. Now, I got four of these for $25, and right now the Amazon seller is out of stock, but there will be some links to eBay. They're quite affordable there also. This company also sells a couple other products that are just like this. So they have a motor and a couple of servos, so you can check that out. But the brown wire on here is going to be negative, so that's going to go on the right-hand side. And so now we've got a servo and our ESC here. Now you're going to need to make an adapter for your Lego. So here I have a JST cable and a Lego harness. Wire the JST cable to the two center wires of your Lego harness. And it doesn't really matter which way, because you can reverse your throttle direction on the transmitter. But that will go right here. And we'll put some motors on there. And then last, we've got our battery. This is a 3-cell battery. This ESC is supposed to be run on a 2-cell battery, but I haven't had any trouble with the 3-cell. If you want to be on the safe side, then you probably want to go with a 2-cell. So we'll power on the transmitter, power on the radio. We've got a solid light on the radio, so that means it's communicating to the transmitter, and the ESC is flashing, ready to go. So now we should have proportional control over that servo. Oh, very nice. It's so satisfying. And proportional control on our motors. And seems to deliver plenty of current for a couple of Lego motors. No problem. I was running four of them at one time. There were four L motors, actually. So we have, just in case I missed some prices here, we've got the servo and radio. That was $30. I got a four pack of these servos for $25. The ESC was $9. This battery cost me just over $10. And then you can get extra radios. They're only $7 each. And then you're going to need a couple little bits and pieces, soldering iron, extra Lego harness, and some JST connectors, and you are good to go. All right. Thanks for watching.